really care about you. That pain does not end when you're gone. That pain continues for years and years and years. You know, it lives with inside your family. So, you know, take a knee, you know, pray, you know, do something for yourself to put you in that uncomfortable situation to at least somewhat get used to it again. You know, it's been 4 years since I've been out, and I've had to slowly do that. I'm not saying that, you know, when I sit down in a restaurant or something like that I still don't scan the room and stuff like that, but I'm able to enjoy being around my loved ones and not having to sit in a fucking corner, but be able to sit there and associate, conversate, and talk about things like that. You know, we're always here. You can reach out to any one of us. We're always here. We got your six. And if you're coming to the show in October, man, I'm telling you, you're going to meet some cool people that actually do a lot of good. Upstate Warrior Solution, Veteran Bridge Homes. There's one organization I can't name the name of, but they're having a really big fucking grand opening that's coming back out amongst many more people. So, you know, we're always here for you. We'll always have you back. We always got your six. All right. So, next on the list, which one should we do? Should we do What the Fuck Is Really Going On? Or should we do White Dude Goes Into the Hood?
I mean, my connection was lost there for a second. You there?
Yeah, I'm here, man. All right.
Oh, man, we have technical difficulties. Yeah, go.
White Dudes in the Hood. All right, so here's a little clip by Adam Calhoun that I was looking around and seeing, and I love the way that he done this, and this shows right here, people can get along, and people can agree to disagree, and just still be friends.
About the four black teens that beat up the white handicapped teen in Chicago. Well, I'm in Chicago and I'm interviewing everybody. So while you guys stay safe behind your computers, and I'm interviewing real people, so I hope you enjoy this shit.
I'm Adam. What's up?
Like me, be around this neighborhood.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, man. Like, you don't normally see this, man.
All right, I'm gonna get straight into it.
Okay.
What do you think of the four black teens that kidnapped a white teen or whatever and did what they did with them?
Oh, real talk, man. I post my location on Twitter, man. All them niggas some hoes, man. They bogus as hell.
So if you saw them, would you want to fucking physically harm them?
Boy, I shoot the shit out them niggas.
What's up, guys? You want to be on a video? The four black teens that kidnapped a white dude and beat his ass and all that shit. What do you feel about the situation?
Go ahead. Tell me what you think.
That guy just murdered 9 motherfucking black people in a church, and they ain't even charging with a hate crime.
Right.
They fucking charged him to death.
They want to try to get him death penalty and all of that, but what about
sit him right.
What about these?
They didn't even get fucking jail.
They didn't get no. They didn't try to get them to no death penalty or nothing like that.
But you think that the penalties are more harsh on black people?
They trying to make example out of some confused ass kids. You feel what I'm saying? Right. They don't know the severity of what the fuck they was doing. The man didn't die.
Not a racist concept ever in the whole entire life.
You're saying you don't see race, you're not racist. You don't think you being black and me being white, there's no difference?
That's no difference. Period.
Alright.
Y'all still.
You know a lot of people that are watching this are gonna fucking disagree with what you just
said.
They
can disagree with me.
A lot of black people are gonna disagree.
They can get mad at me. They just gonna hate themselves because they don't have their own.
They're gonna think that I'm telling you to tell me this.
I'm a boss. They can tell their own opinion if they want to. I'm the one that's telling you people that you people need to get it together.
What do you think about Black Lives Matter, the movement? Like BLM.
I can't say anything about nobody else being black. What I can say is that all the people that actually outside, man, that's racist, need to stop this bullshit.
Ask me what I think about it.
Okay. What do you think about black people movement?
I think about black people, I think they matter. Black Lives Matter movement, I say fuck them.
Black Lives Matter
fuck
movement.
Black Lives Matter movement. Fuck that bullshit.
Okay,
that's what I say. Do you like Trump?
Trump himself?
Yeah.
What did I got against him? What did he do to me? You feel me? What did the man do to me?
Hey, what you say? Check it out, fam.
Well, when they say all the things about my family members and everybody
fuck
else.
Trump, you hear me?
No!
Fuck
no.
That man.
Hey, what's your name? What's your name?
My name Looney.
Hold on, come here, Looney. All right, my name's Adam. Nice to meet you. This is Looney. Looney, tell everyone where we're at right now.
We is on Austin, 67 in Austin, man.
Did you hear about the four black teams that kidnapped the white team and beat his ass? What do you think about that?
Man, that's some stupid shit they did. I don't know what they was thinking about, bro.
Bro, what's your name?
Jug, bro. Jug Snow.
Jug, I'm Adam. I'm just going to ask you a couple questions. You heard about the four black teams that kidnapped the white team and beat his ass and all that shit?
Yeah.
If you had one thing to say to those four black teams, or what do you think about what they did?
I feel like it was stupid, you know what I'm saying? If you randomly picking somebody and singling them out, that shit just stupid, you feel what I'm saying? Because it's already enough nonsense.
You think they pit us against each other, blacks and whites?
It's built, it's the system, systematically built for us to fail.
But speaking on those teams, if they were here in front of you right now, would you smack the shit out of them?
I would smack all last one of them motherfucking ass. They disrespectful as hell for doing that to that little ass kid, man.
The young man didn't deserve what he got, you know what I'm saying?
Right, he did.
If it's that act, that random action, I'm strongly against it, because if you ain't got no real beef with somebody, why the fuck would you do some shit like that?
Chirac, this is Chirac.
They call it, you know, it's, they call it that shit because how many guns and how many motherfuckers that's out here shooting them, they shooting them without no sense. You know what I'm saying?
All right, so that right there, I think is a pretty cool piece, because you actually have, you know, black people saying that that is stupid, it's retarded. Why the fuck you singling people out? There ain't no beef and shit like that. And it's not just about that. I mean, all races end up doing this shit. You know, white people will signal out certain people. Mexicans will do the same thing. Asians will do the same thing. They're all a bunch of fucking idiots. I mean, just to single out somebody and to attack them and just hurt them, that is so fucking stupid. You there?
I don't know. We keep having technical difficulties, brother. But yeah, no, I agree wholeheartedly. And I watched the clip yesterday. And, you know, where he's actually located at in Chicago talking to these people is in some pretty gruesome, mean streets in the hood.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and this is a tatted up white guy with a beard that looks complete opposite of somebody who should be walking down them streets. And he's just randomly going up to these people and talking to them. And you can just see it's just human interaction. It's conversation.
That's right.
You know, and these guys are speaking the truth.
That's right.
You know, I grew up in New Orleans. And I was in a school where I was one of three white people in the whole damn building. And racism was never a thing for me. You know, it just kind of, I just fit in with the culture, you know, and it worked. And so I don't ever see that, you know, but I do see it amongst the nation. I still see people trying to fight for something that happened years ago. And I see people trying to, you know, because I mean, think about it. Look how far we've come, you know, from the civil rights movement.
Right.
You know, look how far we've come. I mean, damn, we had a black president. What more do you want? You know, I mean, like, for real, like, you talking about you ain't got no rights and equal opportunities, all this other bullshit. You guys have the same jobs, the same opportunities, same money. You can be famous. You can do whatever the fuck you want to do. It has nothing to do with what happened 100 years ago.
Exactly.
You know, so quit trying to, woe is me. You don't see the Indians still running around talking about how we stole their fucking country from them.
No. Nope.
You know?
And you know, they're, back in the day, you know, we had all kinds of slaves. We had Irish people. We had, you know, black people. We had Mexicans and stuff like that. You know, slavery's done, at least in this country that we know about. And, you know, and there's still stuff going on all over the country. You know, no person, regardless of their skin or their ethnicity, deserves that type of life. What? Not one single bit. Not whatsoever. You know, we're all humans. We all bleed red. We all breathe the same air. We got a planet to take care of. We got to take care of each other, because if we don't, the country's going to continue to go to shit. I mean, the world's going to continue to go to shit like it is right now. Just like overseas. The only reason why they're doing all this shit is because of the two fucking pipelines, like me and Lady Liberty was talking about fucking this past Saturday. Those are two big pipelines. I mean, just think about it. Syria, Iraq, Afghanistan. You know, if they actually sold this stuff.
Bingo.
Exactly. If they would sell this stuff, their countries could be built. And they could give their citizens so much more because they deserve so much more. And maybe a lot of that hostility would fucking end if they would just come together and be like, look, fuck the fighting. let's do something and better our children's lives and better our lives and stuff like that and be a part of the good equation to this world. Because if we don't, it's just going to keep going to a fucking shithole. But I got faith. One day we can get that to work. So
here is my honest tidbit on racism. It's not racism. It's laziness.
Exactly.
And let me explain. Oh, I can't get the job that I was wanting, so I have to come out here and rob a store and sell crack because I don't get the same opportunities the white man does. No, it's because you chose not to. It's because you chose not to get a better education. It's because you chose not to move out of the area that you're in. You chose to be around people that are fucking insignificant in your life. And now you want the government to make up for your shortcomings. Fuck that.
And that goes for all.
Nothing to do with what, because every job I've been in, every college I've been to, I've seen black people there, Hispanic people there, Asian people there. So you can't tell me that it's just white privilege. Just white people get to do this. I mean, y'all have your own exclusive colleges and your own damn, you know, goddamn, what you call it, where they get the free donations, you know what I mean? Like, they their own scholarships, just being black, you know? So don't tell me that the opportunity's not there. It is. Worst case scenario, as long as you ain't got a fucking felony, you know, you could join the damn military. So don't tell me that there's no choice. I'm just in the hood, in it to win it, you know, and it's the white man's fault. No, it's your fucking fault. You're lazy, and your parents made you that way, and now you're making your kids that way. And you want to fucking feed off the government. So fuck that. There is no racism. It's just people being lazy.
And that goes for all types of people, white, black, Mexican, Asian, Latinos, whatever, you know, because there's
no discrimination.
White, yeah, there's, you know, I know some of my high school friends that are just, you know, pretty much, like I said earlier, brain works, facilities working. They're just living up underneath a bridge because they chose a fucking poor decisions in their life. You know, that just goes all the way around. You know, I don't, you know, it, even people have come from bad childhoods and stuff like that who have that determination to actually get out of the hole and actually be something and be somebody and go somewhere with it. But anyway, all right. So, we posted a couple videos up on the page this morning. Some videos that was taken from last year's concert, Operation I Got Your Six, that was in Greenville. Tickets are fixing to be released, y'all. Universe Ticket is going over everything that I submitted to them last night, so that way we can get tickets up for pre-sale and stuff like that. So you can check this out if you go to the Dangerous Grounds YouTube page. Please subscribe to it because all the music videos that we play, all the comedy bits that we play, even get to see some bits from the host of the Dangerous Grounds Network. Go subscribe to it, but you'll be able to see this video. This is Madison Rising playing Pain from Operation I Got Your 6-1 in Greenville, South Carolina.
Pain without love, pain, I can't get enough pain. I like it rough, cause I'd rather feel pain than nothing at all. You're sick of feeling numb. Understand, this life is filled with hurt when happiness doesn't work. Trust me, and take my hand, I'll show you a world you can understand. Pain without love, pain, you'll get enough pain. Like you're up, so